In the last video, we developed the notion of the derivative function. If I give you a function f of x, then there's this new function f prime of x derived from the original function that gives you its derivative. In this video, we're going to talk about how to read off the graph of f prime from the graph of the original function. So let's start with an example. Let's suppose that the original function was the absolute value of x. We want to figure out what is f prime of x at all possible values of x. So let's first look at that when x is positive. So if x is some positive number, what's the slope of the tangent line at this? Let's call this point A. What's the slope of the tangent line at this point? Well, this part of the graph is a straight line. It's the line, y equals x when x is positive. And what's the slope of that line? Well, it's 1. So the derivative function is 1 here. And it's 1 here, and it's 1 here, and it's 1 here, because at all of these points, the slope over here is 1. So whenever x is positive, f prime of x is equal to 1. Now, whenever x is negative, over here, we got a line y equals negative x. See, y equals negative x when x is negative. That's what the absolute value is. And that has a slope of negative 1. So the derivative is negative 1. So this is a graph of the original function. This is a graph of the derivative. The value of this function, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, is the slope of this function, slope 1, slope 1, slope 1, slope 1, slope 1, slope 1. Over here, the slope is negative 1. The value is negative 1. Okay? Let's look at another curve. Here we don't have a formula for it. But let's think about what the shape of the derivative function should look like. So what's the derivative at this point? Well, the tangent line is pretty steep, so the derivative should be large and positive. And here, the derivative should be large and still positive. So the derivative up here is doing something like that. And then as you get closer and closer and closer to A, the slope gets less and less and less. Over here, the slope is still positive, but it's not very big. And by the time we've reached the point A, the slope is no longer positive. The tangent is horizontal. We've reached the top of the hill. At that point, the derivative is 0. What about over here? The slope is negative. It's going downhill. So that means that the derivative is negative. And then it bottoms out. Over here, the slope is 0. It's flat again, which means the derivative is 0 again. Over here, the derivative is positive. Over here, it's more positive. Over here, it's more positive. So roughly speaking, we don't have an exact formula. We don't have it exactly. But we know that the derivative is large and positive, then small and positive, then negative, then small and positive, then large and positive. Because here, it's steep and uphill, shallow and uphill, downhill, shallow and uphill, steep and uphill. Steep and uphill means a large positive derivative. Downhill means a negative derivative. So here's our summary. When you draw the graph of f prime, the value of f prime at a given point is the height of that graph. But it's not the height of the original graph. It's the slope of the original graph. So if you think in terms of the f prime function, f prime of A is the value of f prime at A. If you think of in terms of the original function, it's the derivative of f at A, which is the slope of the original graph. Whenever the original graph is increasing, it's heading uphill, the slope is positive. That means the derivative is positive. Whenever the original function is decreasing, it's heading downhill, the derivative is negative. Whenever the original function levels off, the derivative is zero. In other words, that's where the graph hits the x-axis. So to pull back our example, the original function leveled off at x equals a and at x equals b. F prime of a and f prime of b are zero. Over here, f prime of x is positive. We're above the axis. The slope is, the original function is positive. The original function is increasing. From a to b, the original function is decreasing, so the derivative is negative. From b on, the original function is increasing, so the derivative is positive.